This week, we begin to pray through a section of John's Gospel, John chapters 14 through 17, that comprises some of my favorite chapters of the Bible. These discourses from Christ are part dialogue, part address, and part prayer, while in the upper room at the Last Supper with the apostles. They are in many ways what I consider to be the most important texts for our current focus on building a culture of apostolic mission in the Archdiocese of Denver. Here in this section, we see all three themes of this encounter with the risen Jesus resource. Relationship with Jesus, which leads to a new identity in the Father, which enables us to be sent on mission by the Holy Spirit. What stands out to me most clearly from reading this chapter is the closeness of Jesus's own relationship with the Father and his desire to extend this relationship to us. For many, one of the most significant developments in their walk with God occurs when they truly come to see God differently, that he is a trinity of persons, with each person seeking to have a relationship with us. As he reveals himself to be the Father, we understand our identity as a beloved son or daughter more deeply. This change makes all the difference in the Christian life. For me personally, I count coming to this more profound knowledge of my own sonship in the Father on a silent retreat as one of the most important spiritual moments of my life. We hear that Jesus loves us, or that God is love, so often that these phrases can begin to lose some of their actual impact or meaning. What does it mean that God loves you and me? It means that he knows us individually and wants to come close to each of us personally. I am reminded of a story I heard about some little girls whose dad was working for the U.S. Army in 1952. And because he was deployed and poor, he couldn't come home for Christmas. On Christmas morning, the girls half-heartedly played with their new toys and eventually went outside to play. One of the girls, named Katie, thought she saw her dad in the distance. So she ran inside to tell her mom, but her mom assured her that Daddy said he couldn't make it, and then warned her not to make up stories. Katie recalled what happened next. I turned to go back outside when I heard familiar footsteps. I ran down the stairs. Daddy was home. As I rushed into his outstretched arms, Daddy explained that he had tried everything to get home for Christmas, but without success. At the last minute, a group of the workers had decided to drive, but the nearest guy lived miles away, so Daddy started walking on Christmas Eve until he arrived home. He had walked all night to get home to his family. This story of an unrelenting father whose love drove him to go to such great lengths should remind us of the love of the Father. It is this story that captures the deepest truths of who God is, and given that, who we are, beloved. God's love for us is not passive. It cost him something. God does not just love humanity in a generic way. He loves you. He did not just die for humanity. He died for you. He did not just send the Holy Spirit for the world. He sent him so that your heart would know the love he has for you. The Holy Spirit lives in you, crying out, Abba, Father. Objectively, by baptism, we have been brought into this relationship. But are we daily aware of this kind of closeness and intimacy that the Father desires to have with us? Or do we walk around living our lives completely unaware of who we really are, with our identity still hidden from us? Do we still see God as a distant and uninterested lawgiver watching over us to just make sure that we do not mess up? Do we recognize the kind of personal interest God has in our lives, the specific relationship he wants to have with each one of us? Knowing these truths intellectually is still a far cry from having them really sink into an awareness that we carry with us always. Once we develop that awareness, though, it fundamentally changes the way our faith is lived out. We become bolder, more trusting, more peaceful, less critical. We discover the fruits of the Holy Spirit and can love others in ways we never imagined possible. This week, I invite you to simply let God love you, to let him call you daughter or son in your prayer time. May God bless you abundantly.